What's up, everyone? This is Ken. I'm back with another video. Welcome to my channel. Thank you so much for subscribing, all the new subscribers to the channel. Hopefully you are really enjoying my content. What this video is about, autopilot, not full self-driving beta, but just autopilot. Major fleet out here in the world is autopilot, not FSD beta. So I wanted to kind of go over a couple of situations. Some are good, some are bad. If you've been around my channel for a minute, you know very easily I'll call out something if I need to. And in this video, it'll shed some light on some bad stuff. Not so bad, but some of it is kind of funny. In this video, you won't see me that much. You might hear me talking a little bit in there. I want to not be on camera that much.
I don't really like being on camera anyway.
But yeah, some of this stuff will be a roundabout. It will be the widening of the lanes. Navigate on autopilot. I can't think of it all. There's some kind of fun ones in it as well. And there's some ones that are kind of dangerous if you ask me. So thank you for watching. This will be probably a long video. And if you see any of these scenarios that you want to see any more about, just let me know. Leave me a comment down below. So let's get into it. So this first test is a little crazy, but I think I ran 3 tests on this, and you're going to see in the video what the car does, and let me know what you think. I could not remember if it was the left lane or the right lane, but it turned out to be the right lane, and you will see different scenarios of what's going to happen. So I kind of did it like a night test first. I'm looking at this like you're looking at it right now. And everything was fine. I was like, what's going on? So I wanted to try it again. So I did a second shot of it the same night. There were no cars around. And look at what this does. It literally just changed lanes. I mean, what if there are other cars in there? So you're gonna see, I mean, it's in the daytime, so it's kind of hard to try to do it, but there were no cars coming, the light was green, and it did the same thing. Wow. So we do have some cars. There's gonna be another car in the left lane right there, and you see him holding it really hard there, and it seemed like it wants to go over there, but it knows there's a car there, which that's a great thing. And this one is, there's gonna be a car approaching the other lane, in the left lane, and I'll put like a little arrow there where you can see it, but it's gonna actually turn in the left turning lane, and the car does well. So it's a little confusing. I mean, there was really no car in that lane, but it did good. And the next test, residential neighborhoods, some of them are marked, some of them are not. Did you notice how the steering wheel would turn as the center line would break up? It's really good to have that center line. Check it out. This one is quite funny. You will start with the center line. That's how you can get that autopilot to engage. But then there will be no center line in this residential neighborhood. Actually, it's doing pretty good if you ask me, up until the end. Kind of looking like full self-driving beta. But it actually looked like it was about the parallel park behind that car, so I don't really know about that. I don't know if it was going to hit it, but you have to err on the side of caution. This next scene was pretty impressive as well, I would say. It starts with lines in the road, and then the lines are gone. Kind of looking like FSD Beta, right? So everything looks good, right? But wait till you get to the end. Uh-oh. I mean, it's starting to slow down a little bit. But of course I had to take over. At least autopilot is warning you, but to me it should have warned a little bit earlier than that. Now this is my baby right here. And you're gonna notice why I put a smiley face on there. We're gonna start off with leading center lines, and then this one will be a little bit longer because that road goes pretty good distance, but it will show you kind of how FSD Beta is doing right now. I'm just surprised that autopilot right now is doing it. Don't mean it's gonna do it every time, but I dropped it down a little bit because I was nervous because a car was coming, and you see I almost took it out of autopilot, but I did not because it still have the blue lines. And look at that, it's staying in the lane, which is very impressive. And then it started moving over. It's pretty good. Very good. Yeah! And all this video is, you won't see me too much of this. I'm just letting you see, and I'll speed up some parts of it. I don't want it to be way long, but I'm trying to search for unmarked roads that will set autopilot without any lines in the road. And you're gonna see towards the end, it might be possible, but it didn't work this time. And also, please don't roast me if I'm like, look like I'm going left and right. I'm just, whenever I see the road kind of pop up on the screen, that's when I try to readjust, see if I can get to turn autopilot on. it didn't come on at all. So it's very hard to do that. This is very interesting. I put the speed limit sign up there so you can see what the speed limit sign is, and the school zone is coming up and the speed limit will drop down, and I'll show you a picture of that as well. And then I'll put the speed limit back up and you're gonna see what the car is going to do. There's no school or anything like that, okay? So it's slowing down for that car. It don't know, there's no speed limit on the display at all. And then as you can see, it just like, I think I remember 15 miles per hour, the school zone, so it decided to go 15 miles per hour. Well, as you know, when you're in autopilot, you can only go what this car speed limit is in 5 over, so I have to take it out. This is just a little fun one. I'm sure everybody knows that even like really direct sunlight, it still does very well. So this one, I do this every day at work. There's gonna be a turn off into a neighborhood and it will jerk. But seemed like it was fixed because it didn't do it. That's nighttime. We're gonna try that in the daytime. And you're gonna kinda notice the steering wheel kinda will nudge a little bit very fast, but it's not bad. You can barely feel it. So that was pretty successful. I just slow it down, you see how the steering wheel turned to the left. But one thing is, when I wasn't recording, it did it again. This one is scary. It will almost hit that center concrete divide. I try to do some of my tests day and night. If you couldn't see it now, look in the daytime. Most people would be freaked out. You see that I wasn't freaked out in the video because that is the way I travel from work to home every single day. This is an annoyance. I had to put it on there, and it happens more in the city. It does not pick up the lane lines, and if you turn on to switch lanes, it won't work. But you will see that the lanes will faintly appear. And then I'm going to switch lanes, but look at that, it didn't even switch. There was nobody behind me. But highway and interstate, there is more confident. I really rarely get it not switching or deciding not to switch lanes. So I kind of wanted to just put that in the video. Now the roundabout. I think you all know how this is gonna go. I did it from different angles, but I won't say anything else. I'll just let you look. Now, before I do this last one, those two times that I tried, I had to press the accelerator. Time I pressed the accelerator, it went crazy. Now with this one, it's gonna stop like normal at the yield sign. And then once I pushed the accelerator, it was all the car. Man, it almost, if it would have got around that little corner and then it got pissed and it kept going crazy. One thing with this, I wanted to put this in here for some reason on, if it goes more than like, maybe, I don't know if that's 90 degrees turn, like the steering wheel, it don't like doing it. So FSD beta will solve that. Same type turn, it just gives up. And this is like anytime you're coming out of a neighborhood or somewhere and you're approaching a light on autopilot, don't expect it to pick the lanes. Maybe I should have put in navigation, but I seriously doubt it still would have picked the right lane. But at least it wanted to go, as you'll see right here, it'll go pretty much to go forward, which is cool, but I wanted to go to the right. If it gets near a light and it goes to yellow, it will keep going through, but if it's well before, it will slam on its brakes. Non-working lights, it don't matter, it's gonna stop for it. So I had to keep going, somebody was behind me, so I had to keep accelerating, but you saw it going down. This one is very funny. There's like a brake master's place. You'll see it pop up a little bit, so I had to do a couple of tests to show you what actually it does. So it's the second attempt here. And it did pretty good. Like I said, you get mixed results with autopilot for some reason, but I wanted to try it at night where there's no cars and watch what happens. You see it coming up right there. It literally thinks this is a stop sign and it stopped, made a complete stop. Oh man. You all know, especially you Tesla owners, know any wide merging lanes, it's gonna get in the middle. And like I said, it does good, but it's kind of embarrassing because some people probably behind you are like, what are they doing? And you'll see kind of like on a highway going pretty fast. Look how that display looks. But it becomes stable, but it's still in the middle of the lane when I would be a little bit more to the left. All right, so navigate on autopilot. If you, a lot of you don't know about this, I mean, you Tesla owners, of course you do, you're probably bored. But what I want to show you on this is I turned off lane confirmation because if I had lane confirmation turned off, the car would do the turn signals and everything and merge in itself, but it sucked. Time that lane confirmation suggests, I turn it on because the road widens and the car will be like swerving a little bit, but I did pretty good on this. It could be worse. You saw how it kind of wiggled because that lane was very wide. And then the car is going to suggest me pass this car because that lane was kind of wide and you kind of saw how it was kind of in the middle. I would say that's kind of successful. I don't think a lot of YouTubes have been talking about this, but let's see if they fix the display for the semi-trucks when you're passing them. I'm gonna do a couple of tests on that. As you can see, it still jumps around. I'm gonna do it one more time, speed it up to get to the other truck. But it's not a big deal. The truck is not in real life jumping everywhere, but I think it's just pretty much a software fix. As you can see, it suggested the lane change, but it was kind of too early, so the road kind of turned red, and then once it had enough clearance, it did it. And if you have full self-drive, you know the car will automatically exit the lanes. One thing I want to tell you, there was one YouTuber who had a lot of followers actually, said if you have lane confirmation turned off, the car will not automatically exit the lane. It just did. It will slow down every, I think it's 4 to 5 seconds, and it will turn the brake on every time it does it. I was looking at see if the brake light turned on, which I kind of don't like that, because a car be like, why do you keep pushing on your brakes? But it does really good. It picks the lane, because I am going to be turning right up here to go to my destination. If it's a very sharp turn off of the interstate, it might be a little janky. So hopefully you all enjoyed that video. I wanted to really go in depth and just show you different scenarios that the current autopilot have. Of course, go look at the FSD beta videos. I mean, you're gonna see the future of this software, hopefully. And all my new subscribers, welcome. I really appreciate you hitting that subscribe button. Also hit that notification bell so you will know when I post my videos, and punch that like button. And leave a comment. Let me know what scenario surprised you, what scenario didn't surprise you, or what scenario was just a disaster. I really want to know. But hopefully anyone that is planning on getting a Tesla, just be careful and make sure you always be attentive when you're driving with autopilot, especially in the city.
All right, that's it.
This is YouTube Ken. See you in the next video.